I was talking about off camera about your the network that you created and what it means to me, and I've heard other people talk about the network. So, kudos to you for starting something so phenomenal, so uplifting and inspirational, and refusing to let it become a hookup sex site. Because I think people go into what you do with great ideas, but then it becomes sex. And then the great idea becomes who's got the bigger wee-wee and the best butt, instead of how can I support this person with HIV and AIDS. What has it been like for you having people like Dab Garner on the POZIAM network?
It's having people like Dab and Bob Bowers.
Yeah.
Is one of them, and even Richard Berkowitz.
Yeah.
To have people like that. I mean, I can go down names of people. There's so Jack McEnroe. People like who are out there and doing things and have been surviving for years to come to my network, which is, for me, this little tiny piece of the world, you know, for him then to come and be raving fans of my network.
Right.
And to make, because they make my network, you know, it's people, Kenji, even like you. And Dab, it's people who go around and talk to people. When people are logged on, they chat with people. You know, we have greeters who greet you when you come to the community, and you have a comment on your page the first 2 days you're there by people telling you, welcome to the site. You know, if you need help, reach out.
Right.
And I think that's kind of what set us aside. But I've learned so much from people like Bob Bowers. Like, Bob Bowers is my total hero, mentor, and, like, the most amazing man that I've ever come across. And he reminds me a lot of my father. I don't know if it's the name thing or what it is, but just his personality is so wonderful. It's just like I really want to be like him more and more every day.
Nice.
He's amazing.
Nice. It's, I mean, it's from your network that I've actually made a more conscious effort to reach out to the gay community despite all the roadblocks I've experienced. I've been more vigilant in making sure I continue to make those inroads into the community to reach people that are there just like me, feeling like I'm here but I'm not being supported. And it's, I mean, it was from just reading some blogs on your network that when my case manager said I should talk to Morris, at first I was like, I don't want to talk to Morris. I'm not talking to him. He's black. No, I don't have sex. I don't have success talking with black gay men. No. And then one day we just started talking. And it's interesting that you say what Bob is for you, Morris is very much for me, like a father figure. And he is definitely somebody that I can turn to and ask questions, and it's cool to have that. So thank you for creating POZIAM.
Have you met Morris in person?
Yeah, Morris actually works at AIDS Project Los Angeles. He is now my peer support manager. So him and Tiana kind of tag team me, so to speak. I mean, even with Tiana, case management, I don't have a lot of nice things to say about case management, but Tiana is a case manager who gets it. When I said, when I was homeless on the streets and I said things like, hey, I don't want to go over there because I fight when I'm there, she didn't say, well, try it anyway. She just said, okay, that's off the table. We'll find something else. And it wasn't like, oh, he's just being picky. She actually worked very, very hard to find things that work for me. And I think what happens with ASOs is it's all cookie cutter, and that's not how it works. That's just not how it works. And another thing that you said about your network, you can create friends on your network. I've created friends on your network. What is your ultimate goal for POZIAM?
Oh my. The ultimate goal for POZIAM. I have so many ideas that float around in my head. But overall, I would love for it to become a standalone network.
Mm-hmm.
Again, you know, the money for that is very expensive to do.
Right.
Like, I think I would quote it like $30,000,
mm-hmm.
which is a lot of money to purchase your own platform and things of that nature. But other than that, I'm actually really happy where it's at.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, I would love to expand more on the radio show.
Mm-hmm.
And start some campaigns. I would love to actually have like a POZIAM tour where certain select people would go around and, you know, speak to people about this. And not just kids in high schools. I'm talking about like literally go to neighborhoods.
Right.
And like a town hall meeting and actually sit there and talk to the people who live in the community, because it's the people with HIV are the people who are, they're scared because their community isn't educated.
Mm-hmm.
So if the community gets educated, then the people with the HIV become more comfortable in their skin.
Right. Well, if you're going to do a town hall meeting and you're coming to LA, I know tons of people that will put you and your man up free of charge, and I will work my ass off for a POZIAM town hall meeting here in Los Angeles. Let's talk about your co-hosts on actually, let's talk about Blog Talk Radio and POZIAM on Blog Talk Radio. How did that come to be?
When I first started POZIAM as the network, the site wasn't really moving.
Mm-hmm.
People weren't active on it. They would create profiles and then it would sit,
mm-hmm.
and they wouldn't log on for days, or I would log on. It would only be me and Terry.
Mm-hmm.
Terry's one of the original members.
Okay.
So he would be like, it would only be me and him. And I'm like, well, what do I got to do to get this moving? And Terry's like, you need to do something that's going to bring people back to your site.
Mm-hmm.
You know, whether it be a great blog, or you need something. And, you know, my partner does a radio show, and I was sitting there thinking, you know, I can do this. Because I go and I help out with his radio show as his, like, one of his, I guess, co-hosts.
Mm-hmm.
Who maybe, you know, and I was like, I can do this. I know I can. So that's when I went to Blog Talk Radio, and it's free.
Right.
And I advise people who run ASOs or any kind of an organization that you're trying to get people to hear a message, to go to Blog Talk Radio and start this. It's totally free, and I'm able to go there and give people hope. I just wanted to give people a place where they felt they were comfortable to ask questions.
Mm-hmm.
They were able to just be themselves, and they had a voice. You
right.
know, POZIAM Radio gives people with HIV a voice, and
mm-hmm.
that's something that a lot of people don't have. They feel that there's no hope.
Right. How did you get Jack and Jeremy to be your co-hosts?
Jeremy, actually, I met through Bob Bowers.
Okay.
I went to his website, and he has a list of his friends. And I, you know, I went to his friends, and I invited them to join my network.
Mm-hmm.
And Jeremy joined the original network when I first had it on a different platform. And then he followed me over to the platform on that now. And I always went to his website, and I read his story, and a lot of it I could relate to.
Mm-hmm.
And I just kind of felt this connection with Jeremy, like, our lives passed for a reason. Like, Bob introduced us, there was a reason for it.
Right.
And I couldn't put my finger on it. And then when I started doing the radio show, he was the first person I thought of to be my co-host.
Okay.
So we started doing it once a week. And then when it started getting popular and people would call in and we were getting excited and it was building, I'm like, what if we did this twice a week?
Mm-hmm.
Well, Jeremy couldn't do it on the second day,
mm-hmm.
on Wednesday afternoon, so I had to find somebody else. I found somebody who filled in for maybe, I think, actually one single show.
Mm-hmm.
He did one show with me and never came back on again. I guess it wasn't his thing. He didn't
okay.
want to go out that public, which is cool. Some people don't do that. So I started hosting Wednesday shows, like five of them in a row by myself.
Mm-hmm.
It'd be kind of difficult, you know?
Yeah.
Talking and not having anybody calling in for you. You know, and then Jack, when he emailed me and asked me about being a co-host, I almost fell off my chair.
Yeah.
Because, you know, for people who don't know Jack, you know, he was on Project Runway season 4, and he was openly HIV positive, and he's an amazing man, and he does so many great things, and for him to see something in my little radio show,
mm-hmm.
it meant so much. And he's like, I be interested in co-hosting. And then I had to email him back because I'm like, you gotta be kidding me, he's lying.
When we come back,
I'll tell you about that when we come back.
Yes, thank you for wrapping us up here, Robert.